Nothing. My neighbor's looking at me. Talking and explaining. Okay, he's gone. He's gone. Hi guys, welcome to this new Arabic lesson with me, Maha. Today's lesson is going to be about the 15 ways to respond to thank you in Arabic. Thank you is shukran. If somebody tells me shukran, there are 15 different ways to answer that shukran. We're gonna learn all these in this lesson.
Oh, shukran, Maha.
Shukran, Maha.
Shukran, Maha.
Shukran, Maha.
Shukran, Maha.
Before we start, I want to remind you to subscribe to my channel, turning on the notifications. Please leave a comment below if you like these lessons, if you have any suggestions, any video requests, any lessons that you want me to help you with. I'm also on Instagram if you want to follow me. It's at MahaYakub. And make sure to put a like on my Facebook page at Learn Arabic with Maha. Without further ado, let's begin with the lesson. The first way is the way that you have heard. If you've been learning Arabic, if somebody tells you shukran, you say afwan. That's the most banal and basic way. So we don't want to say afwan anymore. We're going to learn 14 other ways to say afwan and to sound more advanced in Arabic. Afwan literally means for nothing. It's an absolution. It's a forgiveness or a pardon that I'm giving you. So if you tell me shukran, thank you, I'm telling you you're forgiven. You've been forgiven. So that's the literal meaning of afwan, and it's been used like forever and for centuries as a not centuries, anyways, as an answer to somebody who's telling you shukran. Shukran, plainly afwan, okay? Thank you, you're welcome. There are some other ways to say you're welcome rather than saying you're welcome, and that's what I'm going to teach you next. Second way looks a lot like afwan, and it's ilafu, but it's also like enhances your speech, and it shows that you're okay, you're one step better than just simply saying afwan. This is very easy to learn shukran afwan, but ilafu, which means absolutely the same thing, it makes the person listening to you understand that you are an advanced Arabic learner, okay? So ilafu, literally, it's not the adverb afwan, forgiven, but it's ilafu, which is the noun, and it means the forgiveness, okay? Literally, it means the forgiveness or the absolution, okay? You're the pardon, the pardoning. Ilafu, literally, ilafu, the pardoning, okay? So shukran, thank you. Ilafu, afwan or ilafu, they mean the same thing, but ilafu is better and it shows that you're not a beginner anymore. By the way, the ways to say thank you are not only by saying shukran. Shukran is the most basic and used one and common one, but there are a lot of other ways to say shukran, to say thank you in Arabic, and I made a full lesson about it. Click here and it will lead you to the lesson of the different ways to say shukran, to say thank you. This lesson is the answers to these different ways of saying thank you, but again, remember that you can switch between them and use the one that you like or the one that expresses you most into thanking the person that is thanking you. Okay, let's go to the next one. The next one, I use it a lot, and it's this. Walaw, walaw, that's it. Walaw, said in that intonation, walaw, okay, or walaw, it's like you're telling me, what? Don't mention. It's like, what? Don't mention. Don't mention it. I don't want you to thank me for it. Walaw, it's like it's my obligation, or it's something that I loved doing. So you don't need to thank me for. Walaw. Now, walaw can't be translated. Translate. Can't be translated literally into English. Because it happens only in the Arabic spoken language. So, walaw, okay? But say it in that intonation, okay? You're thanking me for helping you with the lesson. I can tell you, really, like, please, it was my pleasure, by saying walaw, like, walaw, or walaw. Okay, just try also to to lift your shoulders a bit and say it. Just repeat it after me. Walaw, okay? Walaw. Don't mention it, okay? There's no explanation, there's no translation, just use it. If you use it after somebody who's telling you shukran, they will understand. And it's like you're saying welcome. The next one is tikram. Tikram. Tikram is an expression taken from the word karam, which means generosity. Karam and kareem, the adjective generous. Tikram is may you be generous, or may God give you the generosity. So there's no need for you to tell me thank you or shukran, because you were already generous with me. So tikram. Tikram is also a way, of course, to say don't mention it, because you're already kareem, you're generous. So I have to be kareem like you. So tikram is like something that you don't owe me anything. by thanking. Don't thank me because you don't owe me because you were already Kareem. So tikram, that's the answer for someone who's telling you shukran. Tikram, just say tikram. Don't think a lot about the philosophy behind the literal meaning. Just say tikram right away. They will understand that it's like saying, it's a very beautiful and polite way, of course, to respond to somebody telling you thank you. And more elaborated, you know, more sophisticated. It's not just a plain, simple afwan. Okay, tikram. And if you're talking to a female, this is one thing that is worth mentioning here. You say tikrami. Okay, you add the e because this is a verb. Tikram, tikrami. So tikrami is you female. Tikram, tikrami. The next one is pretty formal. And used antiquely. It's not used very much nowadays, especially in the spoken language. We don't hear it a lot, but it's a very standard and classical modern standard Arabic expression and way to say, to answer somebody who's telling you shukran. It's la shukr ala wajib. It's a little bit long, so thank God, alhamdulillah, it's not very much used, so you don't have to memorize it. But la shukr ala wajib. Let's repeat it before, and then I'll teach you each and every word, the literal meaning of them, and what is the whole meaning behind la shukr ala wajib. La shukr ala wajib. There's a ayn ala. So la shukr ala wajib. La means no, or there is no. Shukr, which means thanking. There's no thanking. There's no thank you. Ala, on or for. Wajib. Wajib means it's a duty. La shukr ala wajib. There is no thank you for a duty. So there's no need for you to thank me. It was a duty of mine to help you in the first place. Okay? So, لا شكر على واجب. There is no need for you to thank me because it was my duty to help you. Okay? لا شكر على واجب. Okay, maybe I have exaggerated by saying it's not very much used. It is used, but not so much, for example, in the Palestinian dialect. We wouldn't use it a lot. It's more used in formal, we can say it, we can categorize it this way. It's more used in formal situations. Even in spoken Arabic, it might be used, but in more formal situations. شكراً. لا شكر على واجب. لا شكر على واجب. ما تشكرنيش. Don't thank me. لا شكر على واجب. Because it was my wajib, my duty to help you. Another casual way to answer somebody who's telling you shukran is by saying طبعا. Okay? طبعا is very much borrowed from English language or like Western cultures because طبعا means sure or of course. Don't mention it, of course. So طبعا means of course or sure. It's not so much used in the standard Arabic. It might be more used in the spoken Arabic, but it is used by some people, and it's a way to answer somebody who's telling me shukran, taban. Okay, taban. Again, don't mention it. Walau, don't mention it. Taban. La shukr ala wajib. Another way that my father loves a lot to say, which is ta'al kul yom. It's an expression. It has a meaning, but it literally it doesn't work. Maybe it might work. I'll try to translate it for you. Ta'al kul yom. So you are telling me shukran maha for this less wonderful lesson. And I tell you ta'al kul yom. Ta'al kul yom. Ta'al means come. Kul yom, every day. Come every day. Come every day with a request and I'll make it happen. Okay? Ta'al kul yom. Don't worry. It doesn't mean literally come every day and ask me something. It can mean come every minute or come everyone whenever you want. Okay? So it's not specifically indicating kul yom every day, but it's just like it's an invitation to repeat it. If you need a favor, no worries. Just tell it to me and come every day, every time. Come every time you need. Ta'al kul yom. If you're a female, ta'ali. تعالي كل يوم. تعالي كل يوم. So no worries, don't mention it. Come anytime you need me and I'll be here to help you. تعال كل يوم. Another casual way to answer somebody who's telling you shukran is also ولا إشي. ولا إشي. ولا إشي. Again, I'm teaching you expressions that are used in the spoken dialect, in the spoken Arabic. Not necessarily MSA, Modern Standard Arabic, okay? I'm teaching you ways in order for you to speak Arabic and to understand people that are speaking Arabic and not necessarily go and read the Quran and understand everything, because in the Quran you wouldn't see wala ishi. I'm teaching you the Arabic that you are able to use and the Arabic that you need, in short. So again, if you tell me shukran, I can tell you wala ishi. ولا إشي عزة ولا إشي عزة عزة is super beautiful. I have to make a full lesson about عزة and explain different ways to use it and why we use it and why we use it so much. But anyways, ولا إشي literally it means nothing or nothing. So ولا إشي It could have been la ishi, la shay in standard Arabic, and the dialect becomes wala ishi, and it just tells you it's nothing to be thanked for. Okay, shukran, la wala ishi, wala ishi. Don't worry. Very, very similar to saying don't worry, okay? Wala ishi. By the way, we also say don't worry, I might add it. Yeah, ma taqlaqsh. Yeah, it might be in my list. I'll look at my sheets later. So anyways, wala ishi, don't worry. It's nothing for me to have done this a favor to you. So don't say shukran to me for it. Wala ishi. The next one is wala yhimmak. Wala yhimmak, it literally means it shouldn't burden you a lot, because it comes from the word muhim. Muhim means important, so it shouldn't be of so much importance, not in the good meaning, but in the bad meaning. It shouldn't be a big burden or heavy on you to thank me, something that you should thank me for. So don't thank me for it, because wala yhimmak, it shouldn't worry you, it shouldn't bother you. It's very similar to wala ishi, nothing. My neighbor's looking at me talking and explaining. Okay, he's gone. He's gone. Okay, so wala yhimmak, it shouldn't be a lot of, it's not that important, so don't mention it, don't worry. Wala yhimmak. If you're talking to a female and she said thank you, shukran, tell her wala yhimmak. I should work on putting some curtains here, because that's my only source of light in the house, and it's a big window. And let me see what I can do, at least maybe like this. One second. Because after 11 years that I've been doing this, I still feel some awkwardness. Okay, let's see. Can you still? Okay, you can't see me. I'm doing it live, so okay. Now you can see me. Okay, better. Much better. One way that I use a lot, it's shukran ilak. Shukran, you tell me shukran, I tell you shukran ilak. It's a little bit of a literal translation from Italian, grazie, grazie a te, thanks to you. You wouldn't, if somebody tells you thank you wouldn't say thank you, would you, in English? In Italian it happens a lot, and in Arabic sometimes we repeat it. So if you tell me shukran, I tell you shukran ilak. Don't worry, thank you for asking me to do you a favor. Strange, but it works. So shukran ilak if you are a male, and shukran ilak if you're a female. Thank you, shukran. Shukran ilak, shukran ilak. Don't worry, don't mention shukran ilak. Another one similar, sometimes you might hear shukr la Allah, okay? Or shukr lillah, that's the MSA standard Arabic. Shukr la Allah, it means the thanking is to God, not to me. Don't say shukran to me. Don't shukran me, shukran Allah, okay? So shukr la Allah or shukr lillah, they both work and they both mean thanks to God and not to me. Okay, thank God, don't thank me. Shukran, shukr la Allah. Or shukr lillah. Another way is bisurur, which means gladly, okay? So I'm pleased to have done this favor to you. So bisurur, surur means happiness, okay? Or being glad. Bisurur with happiness. So I did it con piacere. In Italian we say con piacere, with a lot of surur, with a lot of happiness. So I did it gladly. Shukran bisurur. Or bikul surur, with all the happiness that there is. Bikul surur. Or bisurur, they are both also fantastic ways to answer somebody who's telling you shukran. The last one, and it's a very much used also one, it's inta btu'mur. Inta or inti btu'mur. Btu'mur, it means you order, you give orders. Not in a bad way, but in a way to tell you can give me even orders. Don't thank me for a favor that I gave you. You can give me orders and I will still fulfill them, okay? That's a very beautiful way, polite way. It's not something harsh or really impolite or anything, because it has the word to order in it. Of course, we don't mean it literally. You shouldn't order anybody, but inti bta'mur, okay? It's very much used between family members or like for friendship situations. You are taking me to the matar, to the airport, and I'm telling you thank you, I really appreciate it, shukran kteer, thank you so much. And you can tell me inti bta'mur. It's not something so big. You can order me. You ordered me to take you, like you asked me, but you can order me anything and I will fulfill it and I will do it to you. Inti bta'mur. Bta'mur comes from the word amr, which means an order. Bta'mur, it's you that orders, okay? In the present tense. Inti bta'mur and inti bta'mri. Ta'umri is you female. Inti bta'umri. Your beloved one, your beloved Arab woman tells you something, a request, and you're on the phone. You can simply, when she tells you shukran, you can tell her inti bta'umri. you can request anything and I will do it. Okay? Don't say shukran to me. In tip to Umri. That's a way to answer her because you told me shukran. Okay? To Umr and to Umri. You can get like rid of inta wa inti. The pronouns to Umr is you, male, and to Umri is you, female. And all of you, and I'm telling you personally, into to Umro. When it comes to Arabic lessons, into to Umro. So to Umro. All of you. I hope you liked this lesson with the whole awkwardness that was going on. But I hope you like it. If you like it, leave a comment below. Subscribe to the channel and follow me on Instagram at MahaYakub and on my Facebook page, Learn Arabic with Maha. And I would like so much to thank my patrons. From the bottom of my heart, you are making it possible for me to make more and more videos, to create more, to work on my book without having to go to school and teach the lessons. I want to thank Omar, Kafir, Joshua, Laura, Craig, Colin, Jamal, Miriam, Dylan, and Michael for your support. Thank you for becoming my patrons and believing in my projects and deciding to support them. Thank you so much. Shukran. And now you have 15 ways to answer my shukran. Okay. I hope to see you in the following Arabic lesson with Miha. Ma'a salama. Bye.